Tonight, on The Pound in Your Pocket, we'll be delving into the BBC archives to bring you some of this.
That doesn't mean, of course, that the pound here in Britain, in your pocket or purse or in your bank, has been devalued.
Some of him?
No, certainly not. I've said this before. I don't know why you repeat the question. Don't you believe me?
And plenty of him, too.
Till tomorrow night, good night.
All this and more tonight on BBC Parliament. Good evening. I'm Cliff Michelmore, and welcome to The Pound in Your Pocket. Tonight we'll be looking back to November 1967, when the government was forced to devalue the pound. It sounds a small matter today, but back then it was a momentous and dramatic occasion. With programmes from the BBC Archive, we'll be showing you how the problems of sterling unfolded. From a currency in crisis and devaluation in November 1967, to the harsh budget of March 1968. Of course, it was a great time for me. I was presenting 24 Hours, the news night of the day, only we were on BBC One.
You can't get away from it, the pound. The suspense is over, the debate starts.
Another day of mystery and confusion in the money world. For a change, it's not only ordinary people who are confused, but the experts as well.
Good evening. In 5 minutes' time, at 6 o'clock, the Prime Minister will speak to the nation about last night's devaluation of the pound from $2.80 to $2.40.
What is the view of the worker here in this assembly plant? We'd like to talk to one or two people here. Excuse me, can you tell me what you thought of devaluation?
No comment. We're no better off for it, are we?
You're no better off for it.
No better off for it.
What do you think the result will be? Could you turn around and just face the camera?
I'd rather not, Alex.
Can you turn and face the camera?
I'd rather not, thank you.
We've also brought together many of the distinguished names and faces of the day to get a sense of the mood of the times. Years ago this weekend, the pound was on its knees. The news was dominated by talk of deficits, speculative attacks on the pound, and the dreaded balance of payments. Britain struggled to pay its way in the world. Harold Wilson inherited this turbulent financial situation from the Conservatives when Labour came to power in October 1964. From the moment they took office, Wilson and his Chancellor, James Callaghan, fought to defend the value of sterling in the face of market speculation, industrial action, and world events. By the autumn of 1967, Wilson and Callaghan were forced to abandon that strategy and think the unthinkable, which meant only one thing: devaluation.
Excuse me, do you know what's meant by devaluation?
No.
Why, lowering the value of it, or whatever it is. You're talking about money. Lowering the value of the money.
It's just losing its value. It's falling, and so everything's going to be worth a lot less.
Well, there, I don't know at all. I'm not at all a financier, so I have no idea at all.
Well, let's see. Do you know what it means?
I'm rather ignorant of politics, I can
say. What would be involved if the pound were devalued? No, I'm not going to answer these sort of questions.
Do you think that the economy is in trouble at the moment?
I should jolly well think it is. Of course it is.
Devaluation is always regarded, or was always regarded, thank heavens we don't have to worry about it now, as more than an economic tool. In fact, the value of the pound is like minimum interest rate. It's something that you manipulate to keep the economy in the condition you wish it to be. But the pound was always regarded as a symbol of British virility, power, strength and pride.
It was first of all not being seen as an economic issue at all. It was seen as absurdly as an issue of patriotism, and anybody who questioned whether in the city or in the press or anywhere else whether this policy was a sensible policy was not really spoken to. It was the ultimate political incorrectness. It was the ultimate unpatriotic thing you could do.
The balance of payments, the trade gap, devaluation. When did you last hear about these terms? We don't talk about these things anymore. And yet they were dominated the 60s. They dominated the government of Harold Wilson. And it is quite extraordinary to what extent we allowed that to happen.
1967 may have seen the summer of love, but it also brought the winter of devaluation. As the money programme discovered, it was a tough time for sterling. The money programme was less than 2 years old, and it opened up the world of business and finance on BBC Two. On the 17th of November 1967, the day before devaluation, as the money programme went on the air, they knew things were bad, but not how bad.